When streaming your own religion application, you may notice that there's two mouse cursors visible in the stream. That's because an additional mouse cursor is provided from Unreal Engine when streaming. This in-game mouse cursor is not necessarily needed, but it depends on how you plan to set up your UI. By either in-game UI or web browser UI. I will show you the most common mouse configurations for both UI methods, but you could of course use any combination of settings to suit your project needs. So the first method is using web browser UI. So, in this scenario, most users want to have free movement of the mouse to be able to interact with the Unreal stream, but also seamlessly interact with the buttons from the surrounding web page, as seen in this example here. For this, we will only use the web browser cursor, not the in-game cursor. So to achieve this setup, the first thing to hide the in-game mouse cursor. Navigate to the Project Settings, Plugins, Pixel Streaming. And set the default cursor class name to use hidden cursor. The second step is to disable mouse lock options from inside Unreal Engine. So navigate again to the project settings and go to the input. Here we will set the default viewport mouse capture mode to capture permanently, including initial mouse down. For most UI methods, this value is sufficient. It means that the stream window will always react to the mouse input, even the first click in the window. Next, we will set the default viewport mouse lock mode to do not lock. Setting this as do not lock means the user can freely click in the surrounding HTML buttons without having to always press escape first to unlock the mouse cursor from the stream window. Please be aware that this setting is overwritten by a mouse lock option in the Cloud RTE project settings. Despite this setting being overwritten while streaming, we still recommend to set the value in Unreal Engine as well, in case you test the project locally without the Cloud RTE settings. The final step would be then to disable mouse lock options in the Cloud RTE platform as well. Now, if you haven't already set up your account on Cloud RTE, then please keep this step in mind for once you're set up on the platform. The next video series after this one will be regarding getting set up on Cloud RTE. So please stay tuned for that one also. So to disable mouse lock in Cloud RTE, go inside your project page and then navigate to Settings, General. Then you'll see in the list here, Mouse Lock, we will disable it. And to reiterate, setting this as disabled means the user can freely click in the surrounding HTML buttons without having to always press Escape first to unlock the mouse cursor. Changing this setting here in Cloud RTE does have some additional effects, however, compared to just disabling in Unreal Engine. When enabled here in Cloud RTE, the mouse cursor provided by the web browser will not only be locked in the stream window, but it will also be made invisible. So if your in-game mouse cursor is also hidden, then you won't have any mouse cursor visible at all. So please keep that in mind. Now I'll show you the optimal mouse settings for projects that use in-game UI. So we will start by returning to the default cursor class name again in the Pixel Streaming plugin settings. This time, however, we will show the in-game mouse cursor by setting it to default cursor. The second step is to set the mouse lock options in Unreal Engine. So navigate again to the input section of the project settings. And double check on the default viewport mouse capture mode that we are using the capture permanently, including initial mouse down, the same value that we used for the other UI method. For the next step, we will set the default viewport mouse lock mode to either one of these lock modes, lock on capture, lock always, or lock in full screen. Using the combination from both of these mouse lock settings allows you, for example, to lock the player camera rotation to the mouse, meaning you can rotate the camera endlessly even when the cursor reaches the border of your game window. Also, using these settings allows your mouse to be fully consumed by the game window, meaning the user doesn't first need to click and then drag in order to rotate the camera. So that's it for the Unreal Engine settings, but as I mentioned before, this mouse lock value will be overwritten by whatever mouse lock value is used in your Cloud RTE project settings. So like last time, the next step is to go into CloudRT and set the same mouse lock option in there too. So go inside your project page in CloudRT and then navigate again to the Settings General tab. And this time we will set the mouse lock to enabled, the same as we have it in Unreal Engine. So the final step for the in-game UI workflow is optional. The step would be to activate the mouse only when your in-game UI is open, because maybe you only want to show the mouse when there's something clickable on the screen. To toggle the visibility of the in-game mouse cursor at runtime, you can simply use the Show Mouse Cursor setting via a blueprint. So to do this, start by opening up a blueprint. We will put the nodes in our player controller, but you can place them wherever you see fit. Now we will get a reference to our player controller, and from there, create a Show Mouse Cursor node and set it to true. The next step is to toggle the input of the in-game mouse at runtime. So usually you can decide if the mouse input should go to your game or to your UI via the Set Input Mode Game Only and Set Input Mode Game and UI blueprint nodes. To form the base of your menu opening closing logic, you would combine the mouse visibility and the mouse input nodes to allow the mouse usage only when the menu is open. So I'll show you a quick example of how that might look. First, I will allow the tab key to add or remove my UI. So let's add the tab keyboard input node. Then add a flip-flop node. Add a create widget node after that. And then we need a widget to assign here, so let's create one fast. I'll go to the UI folder in our content browser. Right click, go to user interface, and select the widget blueprint. And again, widget blueprint. Then name it something useful. I'll call it my UI. Now open it up and we will add a canvas panel, first of all. And then add a button inside this. On the button, the only thing we need to be aware of is the isFocusable setting. We need to disable this, otherwise when we click this button, keyboard inputs will be given to the UI instead of to the game, meaning that pressing tab will not close the menu anymore, but instead cycle through the buttons in your UI. Next on the button, we will create a click event down here that's hooked up to a print string node. So we can see a message on the screen when the button was successfully clicked. So that's it for the UI. We will return to the menu opening closing logic and assign this new widget there. So after this, we will add the UI to the viewport with the Add to Viewport node, and then set the UI as a variable. Now we will utilize the with this UI reference, we will remove the UI when we click the tab a second time. So type remove from parent. We'll use this node here. Now we will utilize the mouse cursor and mouse input nodes that we created previously. So for the menu opening, we will show the mouse cursor. And then connect the input to game and UI node after that. And make sure that the UI reference and the player controller reference is connected here as well. And for the menu closing, we will copy and paste these mouse cursor nodes, but instead set it to hide the cursor. So after this, we will then use the set input to game only node, again with the reference to the UI and the player controller. Just the player controller. Now I'll take a second to check if everything's connected correctly, and we should be able to test the logic by playing the game and pressing tab. So yeah, now we can observe that the mouse is active when the menu is open, and the user is free to click the button in the UI. Additionally, the user can still rotate the camera, but they first have to click in the scene and then drag. Now if I close the menu with tab again, the mouse cursor is inactive and it's fully consumed by the game to allow for endlessly rotating the player camera. So I don't have to worry if my mouse cursor is inside the window anymore. It just takes the input constantly. So that's it for this example, but one final mouse setting you should be aware of is, again, in the project settings. Go to the pixel streaming section, and this one here you may have seen, mouse always attached. This is an additional method to hide the mouse cursor, but it's not recommended to use it, as from our own experience, disabling it stopped the user from being able to double click. Not sure if that's intended to work like that, but we avoided using it. It was enough to use the other settings instead. So that concludes the mouse topic, and you can please continue the next lesson.